5 seconds.
Madam, there is a strong feeling among those who come from the Hindi-speaking areas that we are giving a go-by to Hindi. In fact, it is strange how, in regard to this particular bill or to a measure of this kind, two extreme views could be held and placed before the country or placed before this house. It is said that Hindi is being relegated to the backyard and English will continue throughout this period, and it is further said that even after this 10-year period, the appointment of a committee is just an eyewash, is a way of lull the emotions of the people in so far as adoption of Hindi is concerned. I do not want to say much on that subject. I can only say that the fears and doubts expressed by those who come from Hindi-speaking areas are not at all justified. I must say that Hindi has considerably progressed during the last few years, and if we see the progress which has been made since 1947, it would be found that it is something remarkable. Before 1947, the position of India in so far as various matters and subjects were concerned was low in the list, even as compared to other regional languages of the country. But during the last 15 years, the progress has been so rapid, indeed, enormous progress has been made, and I might say that a large number of books, standard books, have appeared, have been published on literature, history, geography, economics, science, etc. Whatever field you might look into, you will find that most valuable books have been written which could be taken advantage of. I might even admit before the house that although I come from a Hindi area, I cannot really comprehend and understand many of the books written in Hindi. It is a different matter. The point is, I have not progressed along with the development of Hindi. I am behind the times, I must admit it. It is people like me who are behind, and sometimes I feel that my generation perhaps may not be able to catch up with the development of Hindi. The next generation will do so, but a man like me, of course, who knows something of Hindi, feels that I have not been able to catch up with the progress of Hindi. When I saw the two volumes of the Criminal Procedure Code and the Indian Penal Code wholly translated into Hindi by the commission appointed by the Law Minister of the Government of India, I was really surprised. But they have done that job they have completed that job quite a difficult job. So it is both, I mean governmental as well as non-official efforts which have contributed to this progress and development of Hindi. But it is different matter that in spite of this progress, Hindi has yet to be learnt by millions of our people. It is one thing to develop literature and the language as such. It is quite another to make it a common vehicle for its being used by the general population. Even today, if we go into the matter fully, we will find that Hindi is not understood, especially in the South, by the people as a whole. In the administration also, I find that it is not possible by the officers coming from various states, not only from the South, but from other areas also where Hindi is not the regional language. That is not possible for them to work in the secretariat without the use of English language. They have still to do their work in English. And if Hindi is made in any way obligatory, they will be faced with a very difficult situation indeed. Besides that, it has also to be realized that the advantages of English are obvious. I am not one who is well versed in that language. In fact, I know my own limitations. Yet, I would not like to deny the value and importance of the English language. It is no doubt a historical accident that English has assumed an important place in our country, but madam, there were many things which should not be imbibed, which are should not imbibed from Englishmen. But it would be unfortunate if we gave up learning of English only because it had come from the Britishers. English language by itself is one of the richest languages in the world. It has assumed an exceedingly important place as an international language. It is therefore that I make bold to say that if even 2% of our people know the English language, it would be advisable to take advantage of that situation and continue to learn it as one of the foreign languages, both for our national and international requirements. Having said this, madam, it must also be admitted that English could not be continued as our national language and cannot be accepted as our national language. Thank you.